nice walleye. Nice walleye. Get him out. Nice, let's go.
What's going on, guys? Today we're catching walleye through the ice. It's a local lake that's just about, it's only 5 minutes from my front door. So you can't beat that. And we're gonna go fish it. We've been fishing it a lot lately, but we've been only having luck at like between like 6 and 8 o'clock at night. So that's when we're gonna go set up. So for the meantime, I got a new 30-06 rifle that I need to go sight in. So I'm gonna go do that. So stay tuned. We're here at the deer camp. Thought I'd show you guys this gun before we start blowing some rounds off. This is a Browning BBR 30-06. It's just got a low magnum scope on it. But this is gonna be my new coyote dog. Little dog killer. All right, let's get set up and take some shots. Now, there's actually kind of a crazy story on how this gun came into my possession. The gun was owned by a guy that hunts here at this camp with us, that you see in the background. It's our deer camp. And he got in a little bit of trouble. He couldn't keep the guns anymore. Court ordered, he wasn't allowed to have them anymore. But they gave him the option to give them away to friends before they confiscated them. So he did. He gave them to different guys in the camp, and two of the guys ended up, one of them being my uncle, acquired the majority of the guns. Now it's been a couple years since all this. It's 5, 6, almost probably 8 years ago now. Pretty much when I first started hunting here. Now my uncle had the gun, so then he's passing it down. Passed it down to me, and it's not too crazy of a story. It's just a little bit of a weird story how some people acquire guns and stuff over the years. Some of them are pretty interesting. If you got any pretty crazy gun stories, put them in the comments below, and I'd love to read some of them. I'd love to hear some stories on how you acquired them. We got our makeshift target. Let's take some shots. See how sighted in this gun is. Well, looks like the first shot was a couple inches low there, but the The second shot's just high of where I wanted it, so I think that second shot was just shooter error. I was shooting from a stand up, so let's get a shooting rest and see if it's really dialed in.
Check her out.
Well, I'd say that's not bad. The couple just shooter errors, that one way up in the top right shooter error, but really the rest of it's in the spread. That circle's really small, as you can tell. There's the size of my hand. There's that circle there, so that's a pretty good spread for me for what I'm shooting at. As long as I can keep it in that circle, that's a kill. So, can't blame the gun.
Alright, we got that gun sighted in. It's about 2 o'clock now, so in about 3-4 hours, we'll hit the ice and see if we can pull some walleyes up. Catch you guys when we're out there.
Well, we're just about all set up here. Got the outbound fish house. All my gear here. Just a simple little one-man setup. This is beautiful lake. Can't beat it. Fishing about 25, 35 feet of water. And see if we can get on some nice walleye. Well, just caught this nice little walleye here. Nice little 18, 20 incher. Let's get in here and get him back in the water and catch some water. Had a tough time filming it. My GoPro wouldn't work there for a minute, but release. Right on, let's catch some more.
Well guys, I had a little bit of trouble with the GoPro there. Couldn't get her going, but just friggin' hammered one. Nice little guy. Get out in the light so you guys can see it a bit better. Just choked it. Look at that guy there. Hooked up again. That wasn't long at all. Loosen up the drag there. Come off. Oh, he took the head right off my minnow. Let's see if he wants it back. See if he wants it again or not. Baby, hooked up again. These fish fight like crazy. I love it. And I lost them again. God damn it. This fish. I don't know what's going on. I just can't get the hook set on him. Twice now, come on! I don't know what's going on with these fish tonight. I'm gonna get this guy.
Well, stay tuned to see if I can freaking catch this fish or not. Damn. Got him that time. You have to be freaking kidding me. I lost him again. This fish! I have no idea what's going on with him. I'm gonna catch this fish, I swear to God, if I don't. Well, we're hooked up. I don't know if we're ever gonna get this fish out of the hole or not. This might be a pike. Maybe that's what it is, why it keeps getting off. There is pike in this lake. This one's a fighter. Holy. Come on. Oh, nice walleye. Nice walleye. Get him out. Nice, let's go. Let's go. Let's go, baby. That's a tank. Just gagged her. Woo!
Let's go, baby. Look at this giant walleye. Friggin' 28 incher. Let's go, baby. Can't beat that. I literally was just setting up another one. Got it set up, dropped it down. Was trying to get my camera gear all set up. And what do you know? One comes in and hammers it. Just a little guy. But, you know, they all eat. Let's see if we can catch a few more before we head out of here.
I just want to let you guys know, that big walleye, he was just bleeding a little bit because where I hooked him, I got him in the gills a little bit. But I checked him out. He was all good when I put him back down the hole. He wasn't injured at all. He was just spitting a little bit of blood out of the gills. Anyone that fishes a little bit knows it's pretty common. But yeah, just sort of, if you've seen all the blood on the ice and seen it coming out in the video there, then now you know why. All right, well, it's the next day here. I didn't end up filming an outro for that last video, so for yesterday's video, so here it is. We ended up catching 5 walleye. I don't know if I got them all on camera or not. I was having tons of camera difficulties. But yeah, if you guys like the video, then stay tuned. We got lots of snow goose hunts and lots of goose hunts coming up in the future. And I think you guys are gonna like them. We got some coyote hunting and some turkey hunting coming up. And then after that, we're just coyote hunting for the summer, bass fishing. And then we'll have the spring snow goose hunt in Saskatchewan. If you guys want to stay tuned for that, then keep watching and we'll have lots of hunts ahead. Stay tuned.